Was you scared? Did you hear me outside talking? You remember hearing me talking? Okay. And what happened? There was a bullet that came right in between the carpet and landed right underneath Joseph's stomach, right?
No, your feet,
huh? And it didn't hit anybody. It just went. It went through the wall, went through the carpet, didn't it? And landed at your feet, huh?
No, it went through and it stopped in the middle of the carpet and wood.
Oh my! It was exciting, huh? What's your name, Taco? What's your real name?
Isaiah.
How old are you?
Five.
You love Daddy? He adopted you, right?
Yeah.
You love Cyrus and everyone else here? You love the boys and girls here?
Yeah.
You want to say hello to anybody out there, the kids that left?
Yeah.
Say hello. Wave to them.
Hi.
Don't tell them. Make sure that they're taking good care of them.
Make sure they're taking good care of them.
Okay.
Come on.
Anything else you want to say? Maybe you might ask them if you can have some ice cream too, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Ask them.
Can I have some ice cream?
A little bribery there. Mm-hmm. You know, you're considered a big terrorist, you know, and you can demand some important things like an ice cream or something, you know. Maybe they might adhere to you. Okay. Okay, love you. Can I let Crystal come and talk? Okie doke. This is little Crystal. She's my little taco girl. Love Daddy? Huh? That's one thing a lot of kids will tell you about me, and that's that a child's a child. And there's one thing about our children you'll find out is that they're not fakes. They're taught respect. They're taught faith in God. They may not know every doctrine. They may not know everything that we know. But they're taught that authority is based in maturity. They're taught to respect people. And this kind of, if I might say, this kind of refuge of these so-called psychologists, especially this lady out in Dallas. These people saying that our children are abnormal, they're going through some kind of shock. You know, love is a power which allows a human being to have a subdued thought and a subdued reaction to anything. And we need to understand that what may be considered normal to one may not be considered normal to another. But our children, they're not disrespectful. Our children are not over demanding. They're just trying to get along, and they're trying to be able to act and direct their steps as you would have them to. And I think y'all need to really sit back and stop and look at the situation. I think that all you who got kids in the supermarkets who run and scream and who eat all this junk food all the time and all this candy, I think that you people that have all these children who are in school do not want to be spanked by somebody else or are always rebuttal, want to fight against somebody in their authority. You see, I think if you look at the children, you'll see the actual product of the parent. And, you know, Mrs. Kuhn and all these people down there, the social workers, you know, y'all should learn a lesson out of this. Our children is our product that we were offering to society. And, you know, they're totally different than what we've seen the majority of society trying to offer to society. You know, our children know how to respect, they know how to be mindful, they know how to do right because they see it here. They see it in the parents. We subject ourselves to God. We're obedient unto God. We follow the pattern that God would have us to do. Just like Abraham. God says to Abraham that his covenant will be with him because he'll direct his family after him. There's no hypocrites. There's no say, don't do as I do as I say routines practiced here. So anyway, we live for one thing, and that's the betterment of tomorrow's world, and that's where our children come in at. And you people go and think what you want to, but the proof is in the pudding. You know, just don't pervert our kids. That's all I'm asking. Don't pervert our kids. God will hold you in contempt. So you want to say hello? Thanks for the milk. Can you say that? Say it. Thanks for the milk. Crystal doesn't talk very much, but when she does, she talks really well. Hey, you love me? Have a kiss? Thank you. Okay, hop up. Does anybody have anything they want to say? Huh? There's a lot of other children here, but we're just trying to get, you know, some of these, you know, so you can know that we're doing fine. Here's a couple of pictures of some of my other children. This is little Robin before she decided to go back in the world, and that's little Wisdom there. She calls him Sean. Got that zeroed in there, Steve?
Not yet. Okay, hold it as still as you can. Okay, right there.
That's Robin Bonds, and that's little Wizzy there. Yeah, Robin knows I try to talk her out of committing herself in this message because of her little Disney World upbringing. And this is someone here I really cherish. And it just about killed me when I lost this young lady here. But you know, maybe everybody can. This is Dana Okamoto. Dana Okamoto. And this is one of my favorite sons here. They're all my favorite sons, but this is Skyborn and Scooter. The one on the on my left is Sky, and the little guy in the middle there with his mother's holding his Scooter. Got that, Steve?
Yes.
And also I'd like to remind Linda Campion, who I believe still lives in Dallas or Richardson area, daughter of Dick Campion, that no matter how this ends up, you know, I still love Shay Nicole, and I've been putting money back to the side for her, and everything that I taught Linda still sticks. And this is something that this whole nation is going to have to learn. Whether they're going to learn by being sober and listening, or they're going to learn the hard way. I mean, we want to wish the best of you guys, the best of luck. And we ourselves, as I said, are waiting on God. We want to resolve this as much or more so than you do. But we want everyone to stop, and we're listening, and we're looking, and we want to realize, and we want to be convinced that it is realized that political power, the ATF, has done something seriously wrong. I'd like to very quickly show you a few things here from Cliff Sellers, an artist from England. We do custom-made guitars.
What was, when we met him, what was he going to be?
Cliff was going to be a ministerial student for the Seventh Adventist Church. When he found out they didn't have no truth, when I showed him the prophecies and all that, and all the Adventists have is a bunch of hollering about the Pope and all that. I mean, you know, the Pope may be a nice guy, you know? But the thing of it is, you can't be just hollering about somebody else all the time. You got to present doctrine out of a book, and the Adventists don't have that.